Now at four, the nation pauses to reflect 1 year after the January 6th assault on the U.S. Capitol. Hundreds descended on the building in an attempt to stop the certification of the 2020 presidential election results. Thanks so much for joining us at 4 o'clock. I'm Elizabeth Kling.
And I'm Curtis Ming. Our news also streaming live on CBS and Sacramento. Five people died after the attack on the U.S. Capitol, and more than 700 people are charged with crimes stemming from that day. And fiery remarks today at the Capitol. President Biden squarely blamed former President Donald Trump. CBS 13's Natalie Brandt is on Capitol Hill.
These images from 1 year ago when rioters attacked the U.S. Capitol will be forever etched in the minds of the lawmakers and everyone else here on January 6th.
Those of us trapped in the gallery, we lived it. Ducking, crawling, under, over railings, hands, knees, the sounds, the smells.
Former Vice President Dick Cheney joined his daughter, Wyoming Congresswoman Liz Cheney, on the House floor for a moment of silence. In fiery remarks, President Biden put the blame squarely on his predecessor.
For the first time in our history, a president had not just lost an election, he tried to prevent the peaceful transfer of power as a violent mob breached the Capitol. But they failed. They failed.
Former President Trump canceled a planned news conference but released a statement calling today's events, quote, political theater and repeating false claims about the 2020 election.
We were both really looking forward to President Trump's press conference tonight. Unfortunately, I think he got some bad advice in canceling it.
This very chamber where we're gathered today was breached, it was desecrated, as was the rest of the Capitol.
Senate Democrats took to the floor to mark the anniversary and demand passage of voting rights legislation. Later, lawmakers joined demonstrators for a rally and held a candlelight vigil.